against Brooklyn and welcome to my channel. If you're new here, thank you so much for stopping by. I make videos twice a week, so on Tuesdays and on Fridays. And if you're a current subscriber, thank you so much for your continued love and support on my channel. And I'm really hoping you're enjoying my content. So today's video is going to be a brunette hair care routine. So basically, all the products I love for my dark brunette, almost black hair colour. So I've got a few products, and I'm not going to be using until I use up some other products, so let's get started. So we'll start where most normal people would start, and that'll be shampoo for your hair care. So the basic stuff that just washes your hair and makes it clean. So I've got two that I rotate between each one. So the first one is just for general hair. It's Aveeno Skin Relief shampoo. So it's basically meant to be for dry, very dry scalp, just relieves dry, itchy scalp. And sometimes when I do get dry scalp, so this shampoo just soothes my hair, doesn't dry out my hair, actually keeps my hair moisturized, and it just helps like relieve dry skin. It's amazing. So if you suffer from even dry hair, but mainly dry skin, like you tend to get your skin just tends up to be really, really dry in winter, this is really good. I think it's about £8 or something like that, so it's there for like a drugstore shampoo, but it's worth it because it's lasts you ages, and yeah, it's one of my go-to shampoos. I absolutely love it. And a few years ago when my scalp flared up with eczema, this is the only thing I cleared it up, and it's amazing shampoo for that. And touch wood, I'll try to find wood, I'll not get any flare-ups on my scalp or anything. This stuff does, it's amazing. Just try it if you've got dry scalp or eczema or psoriasis on your scalp, just try it, it's amazing. So the next shampoo, which is Colour Depositing for brunette hair. Tell a lie, I've actually got another shampoo, but I'll go on to that in a minute. This one is the Charles Worthington Colourplex Enhancing Brunette Shampoo. I do have a review on my channel on this shampoo. I'll try to link it down below if I remember, but it's a really, really good shampoo for warm brunette hair. I would say it adds more kind of chocolate warm tone to her. So if you do like warm tones to her, you'll love this. But if you prefer cooler toned look to your hair, stay away from this because it does add that warm chestnut chocolate brown tones, and it's lovely, it's really nice. I would say if your hair is anywhere between like a level 6 to a level 3 to 8, like my colour is more like a level 3, I would say it's perfect for you if you like that warm toned look to your hair. And you find sometimes the colour fades in your hair and it just looks too dull, this will leaven it up and brighten it up and add the colours into it. Just, it's amazing. I think it's about, I don't know what the price is, I think it's like £68, so 68, not 68. I wouldn't pay a flipping shampoo out there, but it's around the same price range as this one. So it's very like affordable for like a shampoo. And do you have different colours in this range? So they have one for blonde hair, they have one for like a violet tone shampoo for platinum blonde hair. I've had that shampoo in the past, absolutely loved it when I had my hair bleach blonde. Do you have a blue shampoo for like brunette hair? They have all different types, and yeah, just brilliant. Only downside, it does dry your hair out, so I would definitely say follow up with a wee conditioner mask just to counteract any dryness. And what I like to do with these two shampoos, so for one wash I would just use this shampoo and then condition, then the next wash I use this for my shampoo, sometimes this one first and that one because it can be drying, depends on if I want to really boost the colour. So for instance, my routine would be say for during the week I like to just use conditioning, so just basically condition the hair, like not really taking care of the colour, like not really dealing with the colour, because that's the weekend hair wash, if that makes sense. So for instance, I'll wash my hair on a Monday or Tuesday, that's my conditioning wash. So basically two shampoos of this to kind of just take care of the condition and take care of dry scalp, and then I just condition my hair with like a mask. And then for Fridays, when I want to have my hair a bit more vibrant to the colour, like to be more richer and vibrant, either this with this or just two shampoos of this and a colour deposit and mask conditioner. And yeah, that's the shampoos. The first shampoo, which I'll get on to now while we're on the topic of shampoo, it's this Matrix Dark Envy shampoo. This is amazing for you cool toned brunettes out there, even up the black hair. It's designed for a level 4 to level 1. So level 1's black hair, level 4's the medium, the dark brown hair. This stuff is a green colour deposit shampoo, so it tones out any unranted? What? Tea's having a rant here. Okay, wise up. But unwanted brassy red tones. It's perfect, so if you like more of that ashier, cool toned, like even like on like that blue toned brown hair, you'll love this. It does, I know I'm gonna sound really, really silly when I say this, but it does kind of give a slight green cast to her, but it isn't that noticeable. It's actually nice because it is like a good green shampoo. Oh, I don't want to get it everywhere, but you can see it there, hopefully. It's a good green shampoo to get anywhere. No, I didn't get any on me, so yeah. But just toned your hair. I would say if you're anywhere like lighter than a level 4, like a dark brown, don't use this because it will make her green. But if you're like the dark brown, the black range, and you like a cool toned shampoo, like cool toned hair, definitely try this. I haven't seen any more like green toning shampoos, only seen this one. Basically, it's similar to what a purple shampoo would do on bleach blonde hair, just tones out any unwanted tones in your hair. But the reason why I don't use this until I use up the brown one, because these are two opposite tones, and I wanna use up this shampoo and the colour deposit and conditioner before I break into this. I am planning on to use up more products to get the mask. This comes with conditioner and a mask, you can get just buy them separately around the gallery. I want to get the mask of this because it's more like that colour deposit and mask, and might consider getting that one, the mask, the dark Eddie mask. I think that's my next kind of thing when I use up more hair stuff. But because these are two opposite tones, it would make sense for me to just alterate them. So I did use this a couple of times throughout December to test it out, and one time what made me decide to test it out was I was about to get ready for a night out, and I was about to wash my hair like you always do, and I was deciding between this one, and I really wanted to try the Dark Envy. I had got it for a Black Friday sale in Lookfantastic online, and I told myself I wasn't going to touch it until I used this shampoo up, but I kind of went back on myself. But I was like, you know what, I want to try it out and see what it's like. It's a night out. What can possibly go wrong? But it actually turned out really, really lovely. So I used this in my hair as well as my really like colour refresh in black. And my hair was like proper dark envy, pretty much. Lovely dark curls I had in my hair that night. I absolutely loved the way my hair turned out. But definitely can't wait to use this shampoo up and start on this one. But just giving you a few options are like, I think this video will gear towards more warmer and cooler tone brunettes. Particularly more for like the darker brunettes, but yeah, that's my shampoos covered. Okay, so now on to the masks. So I'm gonna start with just the regular deep conditioner masks. The thing about me, because my hair has been bleach blonde and every colour under the rainbow, the parts from, I would say, about here down, it's all like that bleach porous damaged hair. So I find regular conditioners don't do it for me. I have to have a deep leave-in mask. So my two go-tos at the minute. I do have other favourites, but I will try to do a different video on masks and my favourite masks and treatments for damaged hair. But I'll start with these two. Now, I know they are dear masks. I do get a discount on them because I do have a Sally's card, but they're more of the high-end salon quality masks, and they're both by L'Oreal. I'll go into this one while I'm at it. The Salon X, no, Series Expert. It's their Lipium Absolute Repair mask. So basically in this one, these actually look very, very similar because they're both yellow tubes. I couldn't for the life of me figure out the difference, so I bought both because I realised they were both with different names, but thought they were similar, so I just got both. But this one is like meant to be a mask to repair really damaged hair. I find it does. It's more, it works with your hair. It actually has protein in it. It's like a protein and moisture mask, so it's meant to like work with the fibers in your hair, like the cortex and stuff like that, and really repair that and get your hair to a healthier state. It has a strong florally, like hair care smell. I don't have that much left because I've been using it to death. It's a good mask. I absolutely love it. I absolutely love it. It's really good for like repairing damaged hair and helping your hair feel great. But I think I prefer the not absolute repair, the Nutrifier mask. This one is a bigger size. Obviously, this one, but you can get this one in a bigger size and this one in a smaller size. And this one is more for like dry hair. It actually makes your hair feel really, really silky soft. It's brilliant. Both of them make your hair feel amazing. This one makes your hair like feel silky soft. This one has a more fruitier smell to it, and it's a thick mask. Both of them are quite thick, but they spread in your hair quite easily. I did use this one today in the shower, and it actually snuck a bit of my boyfriend, Lee Stafford's, I'm not my boyfriend, my fiance's, Lee Stafford hair growth shampoo. I know, sorry, Connor. Oh, remember your hair growth shampoo?
Yeah.
I've been using it.
Okay. Yeah,
I know. But yeah, did sneak a bit of my fiance's hair growth shampoo, which is amazing for boosting your hair. But I did use this today and my hair feels really nice and silky smooth. I find this one kind of does more of the repairing into your hair. This one kind of repairs like obviously in and out, but it more makes your hair feel silkier. This one just kind of helps repair your hair inside and out. So both of them are really good, but I prefer this one for the way it makes my hair feel. But currently these are my two favourite kind of non-colour depositing treatment masks. And while we're at it, I'm gonna get into the colour depositing conditioners and masks. Now, before I talk about them, I'm gonna give you a recommendation for a budget-friendly mask. Now, the Garnier Hair Food banana one and the Garnier Hair Food coconut one, they are amazing for like drugstore products because they're amazing hair masks. And I did have them in favourite videos like last year. They're brilliant. I would say they're just as good as them L'Oreal ones. They're just really, really brilliant masks. And they're perfect for if you're on a budget and you want to have a good mask. And they're all natural, so that's good. But now getting on to the colour depositing conditioner masks. So this John Frieda Defy Grey conditioner is more like just your regular surface conditioner, but it does have coloured pigments. The same kind of tone as the Charlotte Worthington brunette enhancing shampoo, the same kind of warm chestnut chocolate brunette, perfect for like blending away faded color. It's meant to be for people who are starting to get their first grays, like people who are born with naturally dark hair and don't like the color of their hair, or people who, like myself, find their color does fade sometimes and like to keep it as rich as possible. This one's perfect if you love them warm chestnut chocolate brown colours. And the same as with the shampoo, if you're between a base 6 to like a 3 or 2, this is perfect for you. It's just really nice. I would say it shows up more if you have lighter brown hair because it adds more lemon tones, but you can't see them when you have dark hair like me. It just adds more of that warm chestnut tone to my hair. Obviously, it doesn't lift my colour because you can't lift dark colour with light colour because it just doesn't work like that. I'm not going lighter, I'm just adding tones because I like to have them rich, warm tones. That's what I'm getting, that's the phase I'm getting into now because I'm trying to keep them warm tones. But obviously once I use up the warm brunette like shampoo and conditioner, I will move on to the cool ones. But I have been using the second mask as well to keep it dark, if that makes sense. If you're getting any kind of sort of sense in my voice in this video, you deserve a gold star. But yeah, this conditioner, I think it's about £6. I'm not entirely sure. I'll try to link down these products, but this one's fairly affordable. I do find this is very kind of moisturising for your hair. It doesn't dry your hair out or anything. It actually makes your hair feel lovely. And I find, let me smell it. It has that kind of the conditiony florally smell to it. It isn't too strong of a smell. I wish it smelled like chocolate, to be fair. I know I love chocolate smell in hair products. I'm weirdo, but it does a job. It just adds some nice warm tones to it, and it's good if you're just looking for like a subtle kind of color enhancing conditioner, color depositing. Now on the heavy duty color depositing mask, my holy grail. I would not be without this mask in my hair care routine. I've had several shades of this mask, from a red hair to a darker, as well as the Revlon Color Ball. This is the Marine Halo Color Refresh? What? Color Refresh in the shade Black. Now, I think there's gloves. Is there gloves on like that? No, it just came off. I thought I felt gloves in that thing. I must be getting delusional because I thought it was gloves in there, but it's not, it's just the flipping label coming off. If I had a brain, I'd be dangerous. But this stuff is amazing for making your hair colour enhance. So, enhancing your hair colour and making it richer. So, it's perfect for anyone who has a colour it's hard to maintain. Now, obviously, the dark brown is hard to maintain. No. Obviously, the dark brown is easy enough to maintain, but I'm talking about people who have red hair getting the red color deposit masks. And even with dark hair, sometimes you do find it does fade, and I find my dark hair still does fade, obviously because the ends of my hair is still bleached, and I need to have something to keep up the color without being damaging. None of these products are damaging to the hair, none of the color deposit products are damaging to the hair. Bar the charge wearing didn't be a bit drawn, but that's easy, like rectified with a mask. So yeah, but this stuff does not damage your hair. People sometimes think any color damages your hair, like any even semi-permanent shampoos and all. No, this stuff won't damage your hair. It just adds lovely moisture and color to your hair. The colorless black is more like a blue black. It isn't like it's not like wild darker than the color I have in my hair. Similar, like it just kind of deepens it a bit. It's similar to like that base free, but it will work on a true black hair color. I do have one called Caco Intense, which is more like a base four. This is a base two, so it's perfect for like anyone from base three to base one, so like really dark brown to black, like my kind of color. But if you're anything lighter than me, I would say getting the Caco Intense, which is a base four, would be perfect for you. But they do have loads of different colours in this, but I've used this deaf. I've still got loads left, but I've used it loads of times, so it's perfect, it's worth it. It's I think it's about, I don't know what the price, I think it's £20 or something like that, so it's steep. But I do get a discount because it's from Sally's. But I would say it's a dear hair product, but it's worth it because you get loads of different applications, like you get tons of applications in the one bottle. They have a smaller, like 100 ml tub if you want to just try it out and see if it works for your hair. This one, I think it's 300 ml. I don't know if it says. I think it's 300 ml. This one. Trying to see what. We'll say it's 300 ml, definitely should be because it's a lot bigger than the 100 ml tub you get. And definitely, like, I find this stuff is amazing for coloured hair, like, it's just amazing for refreshing my dark hair. It makes my hair like even darker and richer looking. And this pairs perfectly with Dark Envy and even perfectly with the Colourplex. But these two things I had in my hair when I got ready for that night out for Christmas, and my hair looked amazing. My hair absolutely looked amazing. So yeah, just goes to show. And it does. It really conditions your hair. So it's like having a mask and a colour in your hair at the same time, like a semi-permanent colour and a mask. That's basically what it is. It's brilliant, absolutely brilliant for your hair. So those two masks I absolutely love. Now I think Revlon Color Ball do have like a dark brown. They don't have a black, but they have a dark brown. So if you're like a dark brown, I would recommend getting their 4.11, like the dark ash brown. It's good for like darker hair, but Marie Nila and Revlon Color Ball do have amazing color ranges, and both I find both of their products are brilliant for keeping the colour and the conditioner in your hair. So while we're talking about colour, I'm gonna go into the actual colour using my roots and what I do when I do colour my hair. I have tons of videos on reviewing some different hair colours. Like if you've watched my videos, you probably do know that I used to have like a black base violet in my hair, but I've changed it obviously the last couple of months to a dark brown, like a black brown. And the colour I do like for that is Garnier Ollier in Base Free, soft black, pretty much. It's like a nice soft black colour. This is like the best colour at for your hair, like it's the best colour brand for your hair. I absolutely love it. It does give a good colour payoff and it's fair conditioning, especially if you've got damaged hair and you still want to colour your hair but you don't want to be too harsh with it. Garnier Ollier is similar to that L'Oreal Inoue because of that oil powered hair colour system, so it's much gentler for your hair. It's like 60% oils in it. Absolutely amazing. My hair feels soft after using this. Obviously, I'm not going to use it until 3 weeks later because I'm trying to spread out the colour application. So usually I wear it on like every 4 weeks, but because I'm trying to like get my hair a little bit healthier and not colour as much and try to see if it gets thick every 6 weeks. So I'm being a good girl and doing that. But if you're looking for a different brand, say for instance you don't want to try out Olia, Live colours are brilliant for your hair. These are slightly more intense. They're more intense than the Olia. I would say they're more drying than the Olia, but the colours do last a bit longer, so they're better for longevity. But Olia is quite good for longevity too, but these ones just stick in your hair, like literally stick in your hair. Now I haven't used a shade per se, but I have used a similar one called Bittersweet Chocolate, which is more cool toned. So this one's more of a warmer toned. It's called Tempting Chocolate. I am going to use it not this time I do my hair, but the next time, so the next 6 weeks. So 9 weeks from now, this will be going into my hair. And obviously, the Tempting Chocolate's like that warm dark brown. I was scared it would turn out a bit lighter than my previous dark hair, but it's not going to because it's still very dark, so it'll be more likely just a warmer dark brown. It's an absolutely gorgeous colour. So Bittersweet Chocolate, the one I have used, I have a review on that too, so I'll link it down below. It's more that cool toned, almost like a blue black, but it's still brown. Absolutely love it. So yeah, but because I like to switch things up, I decided to try this one out. So yeah. And bear in mind, I don't use permanent all over. I just use permanent on the roots because I think if you keep on putting it permanent all over your head, it's just damaging. Like all of your hair, it'll just damage your hair after a while. Even though colour is not nearly as bad for your hair as bleach, but I like to just use the permanent on the roots. And from the mid lengths and ends, I do like to use a semi-permanent, and I'll grab it now. So this is a semi-permanent I like to use on my mid-lengths and ends. It's the Cool Colour by Arabia, this one, and it's in liquid black. So basically like a brown base black. So the girl in Salon Supply said it's like just basically like the same thing as Crazy Colour Natural Black, which is a brown base black. So like closest to what my hair is. And I definitely would say that's true. It's very rich and dark, but it isn't like a proper jet black. It's definitely more a brown based black color, and it does last on your ends quite well. Sometimes I will go in on the mid lengths and ends with the Maria Neila color refresh after doing the root of the permanent color. This one works as well, but this one's more pigmented. This one, the Maria Neila color mask, is more like half color, like half semi permanent color, half of like a just regular treatment mask. This one's straight up semi-permanent colour. No, it's not damaging for your hair. It's actually really good for your hair. Like just as like just like just like the Maria Neila Colour Refresh. Because it is semi-permanent, it's only the positive colour, it isn't going into the cortex of your hair, that makes sense. If you're not a hairdresser, you'd be like, what are you talking about? But semi-permanent colours, only deposit only colours, not gonna like change the chemical thing of your hair, like the chemical structure of your hair. It's just gonna refresh in the colour but not cause damage. So both leads are brilliant, but this one's definitely just more pigmented, like a straight up crazy colour, like semi-permanent colour. So yeah. So speaking of treatments, like after I've washed my hair, I've conditioned my hair, I've rinsed out the mask, I'm ready to dry it. So what do I use? I have a couple of things I use. So leave-in sprays. This one's my favorite. This one, I do like it, but it's all right. It's not the best. It's good enough for now, but I'm just using it up just to get rid of it. It's really staff for Hairology 10-in-1 leave-in treatment. It's not too bad. I've tried better, but this one's decent enough. Just something I'm using to use up, as I said before. But I think it does kind of help your hair to a degree, but not as much as this one. So if you're going to get any one of them, I would definitely say to get this one. I'm not trying to be kind of negative on this one, because I'm sure it's great for people's hair, but I find I get more results with this one. This is the Matrix Total Results 20 Miracle Creator. So basically it's a 21 Herb Effector, similar to what this one does, but I think this one's a lot more superior. I definitely notice an immediate result with my hair after I spray it in my hair. So basically what I do, just a few sprays less and a few sprays less, brush my hair when it's damp. I know people are thinking, oh, why are you brushing your hair? I do use one of them tangle teaser finger brushes, so they're not bad for your hair. Brush it through, and then what I do is I use my Olaplex. Now obviously I have got this from Sally, so it's a lot cheaper than what it normally is. It's expensive, but I think there's good products on the market that are affordable, like that Bedhead Motormouth leave-in blow dry cream. It's brilliant and it makes your hair feel amazing. This stuff is good, I love it. I love Olaplex, but it's not stuff I'm gonna be running to buy every time I run out. It's just something to buy if I'm in Sally's and I want to have a good treatment for my hair. I do find it does help your hair, and this is number six if you're wondering, just the blonde smoother. It does help make your hair feel nice and smooth and just keep your hair healthy. So yeah, I do like that one. Put that in like about that much into my hair and just rub it through, like from here, like to the end. Brush it through and then I finish off with an oil. So what I like to do is use this Aussie Miracle Oil, just a nourish oil. It's okay, it's nice enough oil. I do prefer the macadamia oil. Hair serum, that's the best one I've ever tried, as well as the Maria Neela True Soft Argan Oil. That's a really amazing one, but this one's gonna do for now, but I will get a different one when this runs out. I think I'll just go for my macadamia oil because that one's amazing. But this does help make your hair feel nice and smooth and nourished, but I do prefer the macadamia or the Maria Neela Argan Oil. So that's that. And after a blow dry my hair, I do go in with more oil just to make sure it's nice and smooth. But if I am straightening my hair, I will just, this has leave-in heat protectant in it too, so don't worry. I will go in with more of this if I'm straightening my hair, just a few spritzes more. And then just straighten my hair and then put a bit of oil on. That's how I do it. And that's my hair. I haven't straightened it now, but I have blow dried it straight. To be honest, I rarely straighten my hair. I just blow dry it straight and that's it. Most times I wash my hair. Sometimes I curl it, sometimes I do, but I don't. Well, loads of times I don't. Just blow dry it straight and that's it. But yeah, I do like my hair curl, but I'm not excessive with it. But you're probably thinking, yeah, you are, because you've got loads of products you're showing us. But no, I'm not too bad. But the last thing, well, a couple of last things I have to show you is Lee's hair growth. So this is the Tackle Hair Growth. I don't have a problem with my hair growing or anything, because my hair grows really quickly, but because I've got a lot of like breakage from bleach and damage from bleach, I'm trying to grow that out as quickly as I can. So I like to use products to speed up my hair growth and get my hair like into a healthier state, just growing out the new hair so I can cut off the old hair and be done with it. This is Lee Stafford Hair Growth Scalp Treatment. You just put a couple of pipettes into your scalp, the separate areas, like section of your hair, and just kind of scoot it down each kind of part of your hair. My fiance loves this stuff too. He has his own bottle, so don't worry, I'm not stealing his. Like the shampoo. But this stuff is absolutely amazing. About two-thirds finish with a bottle, definitely will repurchase it because it's that good. I find when I do use it, the baby hairs around my hairline become thicker and they're more like noticeable. And when I do color my hair, like my hairline just looks snatched, absolutely snatched. It's amazing stuff. I do think it does help your hair grow and be thicker and help your hair and scalp and all be healthier. It's good for that. I think it's about 8 or 10 pounds, so it's dear for a drugstore, but it does last you absolutely ages, so it's worth it. So another thing for hair growth is these Hair Boost Healthy Hair Vitamins. Now these are £24, so they're dear. They're like £24, £25. But I would definitely say if you're gonna get them when they're on like the Holland & Barrett buy one get one for a penny sale, because you get two for the price of one, basically, pretty much. And these, I've only just started using them like last week, so I've used them for a week, and I think I've started to notice a bit of a difference with them now. I notice less hair comes out of the brush, like less kind of hair fall, and I notice my hair just feels like slightly healthier more at the roots. But it's going to take a while for me to really notice difference with these, but I've heard so many good reviews on them. And because I'm getting married this year, I decided just to try them out and grow out as much of this unhealthy hair and get it cut and my hair to be as healthy as possible on my wedding day and beyond. So I've got a spare bottle once these runs out, but if they do really work for my hair, after a while I will be repurchasing them until my hair is like at that healthy state. But I think I'll still continue to use them. I do have different variants of this hair vitamins. I have chewable ones. If you don't like to swallow like big tablets, these ones are quite big vitamins. I'll try to show you. They come in this wee box. The smell, it's alright, it's a bit sickening after a while. But they're like literally big tablets. You take two a day. So we don't like big tablets. Do you have chewable ones? And also unicorn vegan chewable ones too. And I have ones for men, ones for like pregnancy, new mums, ones for people who are over 35, sorry. So they've got different options for different people and different people's hair needs. I just have the regular healthy hair vitamins and so far so good. So last but not least, I haven't actually used this product before. I haven't really touched it. But this is the L'Oreal Magic Retouch for roots. I've got it in the shade dark brown. Basically the root spray. It comes like I have sprayed it in the thing. I know it looks disgusting, but I haven't tried it in my hair just yet. I will do a testing video on it because I haven't had a chance to really let my roots grow and have to properly cover them up. But obviously, it's gonna come in handy for like these next couple of weeks when my roots do when the roots do start to grow free and start to look bad. This is gonna be a lifesaver just to spray across the pattern and hide them pesky. To hide them pesky roots. There you go. But I think this is about £6 or 5 or 6 pounds, sometimes cheaper. Get it in Savers, it's cheaper in Savers. They do have a load of different hair colours, like from really, really light platinum blonde to like black. If this is too light for me and I use it up, I think I will go for the dark iced brown or the black, depending on whatever one suits. But I think this will be fine because I'll just blend it in them roots until in 6 weeks and I get my hair done in 3 weeks' time. So it'll be handy. I definitely am going to use a Garnier Ulia free for my hair next time I do it. And obviously my cool colour, semi-permanent liquid black on the ends. And I will do a wee video reviewing that too. I haven't used the straight base free from Garnier Ulia, but I have used a similar one, which is the free two free from their new midnight range. And I have a review on that, the black amber colour. Black amber colour. Brooklyn speak properly, love. But yeah. That is all my hair care favourites. I do have some other recommendations which aren't in my current rotation. I have tried them in the past, but if you want to see like a detailed recommendations on shampoos, masks, hair colours, color deposits and conditioners, like styling products, stuff, just let me know and I will do a detailed video on that. But as usual, I hope you enjoyed this video, I hope I didn't ramble too much, and I'll see you again for the next one. Stay gorgeous, God bless, bye. This is the darkest brown Brasilia color conditioner, which comes with the box color, and it's brilliant. It does add that richness to your hair and it helps it stop looking faded. It stops that faded look to your hair and just makes your hair look like it's been freshly coloured. Bear in mind it does have a slight bit of a purple undertone, which I did notice when I was rinsing the colour out. But it doesn't show purple in your hair, so don't be worrying, don't be panicking if it does. I think it's just a cool tone to it. But it's brilliant for retouching the colour. I did use this on the ends when I got the culprit for the roots because I wanted to just refresh that up and I hadn't put any colour conditioner in my hair on the ends, or like the semi-permanent on the ends that time. I will have that video linked down below. That one's up before that, I think it is. But yeah. But this colour conditioner is brilliant, but unfortunately you can't ban it on its own. I hope L'Oreal do come out with this on its own, like say for instance colour deposit and conditioner masks for different hair colours. Just brings out on its own, L'Oreal, please. It's brilliant. So yeah.